Welcome to my crafting channel, where I craft different things. I'll learn a little, you'll learn a little, and we may or may not have fun. So today, what I'm crafting is a DIY mousetrap. I know that sounds a little weird, but remember the tapestry that I made to put in my garage? I have a little bit of a mouse problem in there as well, so I need to get rid of the mice. So what I'm gonna do is I'm making a big mousetrap to catch as many mice as possible. This mousetrap is humane. It's not gonna kill any of the mice, okay? I'm gonna be able to let them go. I know where they're gonna be going. Owls wanna eat them or whatever, that's fine. Bald eagles, whatever eats mice. Not my problem after I release them. And the biggest thing when we do a DIY project is what? What's it gonna cost, right? So if you have a mouse problem, you might think first to call an exterminator. Exterminators can be expensive. They can be anywhere between like $100 to $180, okay? This project should cost you anywhere between 15 and 25 bucks, depending on what you have on hand and what you don't. One female mouse can have up to 8 litters in 1 year. Okay, and they can have up to 5 mice per nest, okay? It doesn't mean only one nest is gonna be, you know, under your house as a mice situation. They're under our house. Or, you know, in your field or in your walls or however it might be happening. When you go to buy, you know, it could even be a humane live mouse trap where it traps them live. It's only gonna catch one mouse, okay? If that mouse had 5 babies and all 4 of those are females, they're all gonna lay 8 litters of 5 freaking mice a year. I decided to do a little bit of research, per the usual, and find out what we can do to get rid of these mice and not kill them because gross. The biggest thing that you're gonna need for this project is a fish tank. This is a 10 gallon fish tank, okay? It is a 12.5 inches tall. Not sure about the width, but this is the biggest thing that you're gonna need. I got this off of walmart.com for like $14.97, and I didn't need to get any of the extra accessories that come with a fish tank, but this is the biggest item that you're gonna need. A drill, a glue gun with glue, just your standard packing tape, nice sharp scissors, an X-Acto knife, cans cleaned out nicely, so no stickiness, a pool noodle, any color of your choice, rubber bands, and these rods, and some cardboard. One of the reasons that I went with a 10 gallon tank is because it is 12.5 inches tall. Not 100% sure how long it is, I can't remember, but the height was the biggest thing because mice can jump up to a foot. I also have a rag laying down. This is a microfiber rag. It's actually really good at catching any of the little weird metal pieces from the cutting the cans. So the very first thing that we want to do is we want to get our cans ready, okay? So you're going to need your can, your X-Acto knife, and your scissors, okay? So what we need to do is we need to cut the top of this part off. What I'm doing is cutting right below this lip, okay? Right below here, and getting it as straight as possible. Whoo, that's a terrible noise. Oh no. So I actually cut some more of the top off to make it completely straight because it was real, real crooked, and we're gonna wanna have a nice straight, flat top, okay? And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut little slits into it. And this is where the other can is gonna sit on top. So I made little slits. So it almost has like a little door just on 2 sides. I didn't make them even, whoops. We'll do the same thing with another can, cut this top part right off. So then you take your 2 cut cans and you try as good as you can to get these little slits that we made to act as like a holder for this. And the can that has the slits in it, the rest of that can is gonna go inside the other can. Try not to bend it. And voila, two cans are connected. Now we need to make sure these stay together. This is where your tape comes in. So I think the easiest way, oh my gosh. So I'm gonna get a nice long piece, make sure I get it long enough to wrap around the can completely.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
All right. And then we're just going to wrap this nicely around the can. Trying to make it as straight as possible. And it didn't go all the way around, so I'm gonna get another small piece to make so it's completely around the cans. So it's nice and, you know, it's got a little bit of sturdiness to it. So the next thing we wanna do is we wanna drill holes in the bottom of each of these cans, which are now gonna be the sides, okay? So what I suggest is take a marker and put a dot. I'm not gonna do it with this close, but put a dot in the middle. Come on, can we focus, please? Sweet mother, put a dot right in the middle where you think the middle's gonna be. So I, right about there, right about there. I mean, there's no need to do like any crazy measurements or anything like that. It doesn't have to be completely perfect as long as it can spin on the board, the thing that we're gonna put on. I'm going to use the smaller drill bit first and then use the bigger drill bit to make the hole a little bit bigger. And then you're just going to drill straight into the hole that you made, okay? Side. Ooh, this is scary now. Now we have two holes. Now what I want to do is I want to take off this drill bit and put the bigger one on because we're going to need that hole just a little bit bigger. I don't know if I can just drill this into the can. I know when I work with wood, you start small and get bigger and bigger so the wood doesn't crack. I don't know, man. All right, this side wasn't so bad. So now I have nice sized holes in the bottoms of these cans. What we're going to do is we're gonna take these rods. These are like skewers for hot dogs or marshmallows or something. So the ends are really pointy. So I'm using two of them and I'm gonna flip them on each side. So each side has a hard end and each side has a pointy end to give it a little bit more leverage. Eventually these are gonna be glued to the sides of the fish tank. So I wanna make sure there's as much stability as possible. So you have to stick these through both the holes, the top and the bottom, okay? And then these are gonna sit in the fish tank and they're gonna roll like this, okay? And then obviously when we get more in the video, you'll see that when the mice try to jump out, this is gonna roll and they're not gonna be able to get out. On the ends of these, so the cans don't slide back and forth, I'm gonna use some rubber bands from the last video that I did. I'm just wrapping it. It broke. Now we have the rubber band with the skewer through the can on one end. And we'll do it to the other end. It's not spinning. It'll loosen that bad boy up. All right. All right, that's not good. We don't want it to stop. You know what? There is a little snaggle guy right here. Okay, so that's spinning real nice with the rubber bands, even if it goes which way or the other. It's moving a little bit, that's fine. not too worried about that. All right, so this is the first of like 5 or 6 of them. I went ahead and finished all of these guys. I've got 6 of them. I don't think I'm gonna need any more. If I do, I'll just make another one really quick. But I did the spin test on all of them, made sure they spin and can go back and forth without stopping. So if a mouse, you know, does that, like comes at it sideways, it's not gonna get caught on the rubber bands. So another big thing of why, even if you go through an exterminator and they, you know, say that they're gonna let the mice go, you don't know where they're letting them go at. And I found out that mice can find their original nest up to 6 miles, okay? So if you are catching mice and you're thinking putting them back in the field or the park down the street and they're not coming back, guess what? Think again. 6 miles. And oh, if you have like a river in between you and wherever you're going, they can also swim up to a 1/2 mile. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna glue these bad boys to the sides of this here fish tank, and I'll show you how to do it. So what we need to do is we need to take our spinny cans that we made, and we're going to glue them to the fish tank. Now these rods were the perfect size for this fish tank for me to be able to glue them. If you get something different, you may have to measure out and cut them, but these were like the perfect size. This is what it looks like. It's not completely done, but this is what it's going to look like. As you can see, I got lots of drippage going from the hot glue. That's okay, this doesn't need to be pretty. It's catching mice. But if they try to jump in, they'll roll down. Once they're down here, they try to jump up, they're just gonna roll right back into this. And since this is a foot tall, they're not gonna, or it's over a foot tall, they're not gonna be able to jump out. I'm trying to get as much as this excess glue that's dripped on the bottom as I can. But some spots, like there's some way down here in the bottom from this that I can't get to because I don't want to, you know, risk breaking these. But try to get as much excess glue off as you can. That way they can't, like, I don't know, try to eat it or use it against me. I don't know, okay? Just use this glue super generously. Make sure this thing is sturdy. Make sure you're getting all that excess stringy glue, okay? Because you don't want your cans to stick when they try to run up them. Otherwise, they'll actually be able to run up them. So this is what it looks like from a top view. Just wanted to show you guys so you can see what I'm seeing. And this is one of the reasons that we need the cardboard, okay? So they're gonna be able to fall down this, but they can climb up those rods real easily, okay? You want it to be on each side like so. I also cut a piece for over here. So we're gonna glue all this here, just like so. And this is gonna give them a place to walk. And then it'll make sure that they can't get in and out of the trap. So I went ahead and glued the crap out of this cardboard to this, and it is actually pretty darn sturdy. I was a little worried at first. Ooh, that was still hot, but it actually worked really, really, really well. Next, we're going to use our pool noodle and we're gonna cut it. This is what they're going to climb up to get actually into this trap. My husband had a really good point about the pool noodle, was saying that they're just going to chew the crap out of it. I realized he was right. So there's a huge piece of plywood out in my garage that's almost the perfect length to this. So I'm just gonna lay it nicely against this and maybe put a weight in front of it so it doesn't slide. This is the finished product. So here is that piece of plywood that I was talking about. I put a weight at the bottom so it doesn't slide. So the nice railway right up to it, right into the trap, and I'm gonna go get some food. I'm gonna line it all the way up all over that cardboard, also inside as well. And let's give this a day and let's come back tomorrow and let's see if we get anything. Day one, we have not caught anything yet. And I realize that I'm not sure if this might be the perfect railway for them that they're going to, because there's another part of my garage that has a lot more mouse poop on it. And what I used was oats. My husband said that oats was a really good idea. I'm not seeing any trace of mice. I don't see any mouse poop or pee anywhere on the board. I mean, I'm obviously gonna give this a couple more days, but let's move this to a different spot and see if it works better. I actually moved this in my garage because if you can actually see all that mouse poop underneath there. So over here is a way more busier highway for these little creatures. So I moved this because it's been 24 hours and we haven't caught a single guy. I have some oats in there. I don't know if that's the best thing to use. I'm gonna Google some more stuff and see what's better to use. Possibly bird seed. I'll let you guys know what I find out. So we are at day two and we don't have any mice, but they are being attracted. I put some dog food on here along with some oats. They are being attracted by the dog food because there was a lot more dog food on this morning. What I'm also going to do is add a little bit of peanut butter on the inside of the glass. And I'm also going to take this top guy out just in case they're able to climb on the rod and climb up into that. So, all right. Okay, so I'm just gonna smear it right about here. Should be okay. Just a nice gob to attract them, and I'll do one on the other side too. Day three and still nothing. And I can't tell if they're getting inside there or not and getting out. I got some peanut butter in there. It has been very cold. It's been in the teens. I think it was like 11 degrees the other night, the second night that this was out here. So it could be a little cold for them to be traveling out. We'll give this one more day or two and we'll, I don't know. I think this might be a bust, guys. Still no mice. Day four, I believe. And I'm pretty sure they're just eating away at the freaking peanut butter! Decided to bring this back inside and reconstructure it a little bit. So I think this is too short. Now, according to Google, mice can only jump a foot. This is a 12.5 inches, but I'm thinking they're hopping up on the little spules and such down here and being able to climb up on this cardboard. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rip this cardboard up. I'm gonna take flat cardboard and make it come straight up the sides, and then take this cardboard and place it on top of that so this is twice as tall. We'll see how sturdy it is. So I ripped up all the cardboard off of the edges. I tried to get all the glue off as much as possible because I want to set that other cardboard, hoping that it sits nicely in the grooves and I can just glue it. We'll see. What I'm using is a chip box that we got from the grocery store, and I cut the lid part off, cut the side off so it's inside out because this side's more like they'll slip on it more than the other, than the just the brown side. And this will go almost snug, almost perfect. I'll just have to put a piece of wood here and hope for the best. It's just got a little bit of open side right here, not very much. So just gonna take one of these bad boys, plop it right on there, run that ramp right up to the top. So this is what we have now. We have a very tall trap. All I did was take that box and glue it to top of the fish tank, okay? Made it so there was no access to be able to get out or in from right here, because the only way in should be the top. And I made this small little guy, so maybe it'll take off their depth perception and it won't seem like it's that far down. And since I'm hoping they've been in here once before and they think they can get out, that they'll
hop back down in there.
I still haven't caught anything, and it's almost been a week. Nothing is in there. I don't even know if they're getting in there. I can't tell. I mean, I'm gonna leave this out here because I'm not doing anything in my garage right now. In the future, if I do catch anything, I'll post another video. But for now, we're gonna say that this mousetrap was a bust and don't waste your time.
I have not caught a single mouse. So we're just gonna chop this up as a bust and call it a day, because it's been now a week and this has not caught anything, even with all the modifications and everything that I've done. It hasn't caught a single mouse. So I'm just gonna leave it out there, because I mean, it's still winter, so there's not a whole lot for me to be able to even do with that thing. So I'm just gonna leave it out there, and if it does catch anything, I'll post another video. But we're gonna call this a fail, because I wasted a bunch of time on this stupid mousetrap. Let me know what you guys think. I definitely had fun doing it. It was neat to try and create something of that nature. Next video, let's hope it's not so much of a fail and let's go for a win. But let me know what you guys think. Leave a comment. Give us some advice on what to do. I'll try and fix it. Maybe post another video. I don't know. Thanks for watching though. I hope you guys learned something new, because I know I did. Peace.